Okay, let me show you the shortcut. I need you to see, there's a difference. Expo, Sharpie. I'm about to write on the screen with the Expo marker. That Y equals 3 line is right here. Obviously, draw a straighter line than I did. And then from here, we can do that counting trick. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Same thing for the B. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. From the line. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. C. 1, whoopsie daisies. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And D. Again, from the line we drawn. It's a little crooked, but I'm going to start it right there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Notice it lines up with that other point. They look about the same, but reflected. So that should be our answer. Hit submit. Boom. Since we use the Expo, theoretically, I use my little handkerchief here. I should be able to wipe that Expo marker away. Okay, now obviously if you put a bunch of Expo on it, you're probably going to want to clean it off after a while because your screen's going to get nasty. Okay. Again, reflect over the X-axis. We already gone over that. And X equals 1. Again, go back to Desmos if you forgot. Type in X equals 1. That's a vertical line at the 1. So, using the Expo, X equals 1 is right here. And we can just count. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. E would be 1, 2, 1, 2. D, 1, 2, 1, 2, and then G, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, same thing as the F, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and indeed it lines up, it's reflected over X equals 1, submit. Okay, there you go. Again, use Desmos if there's an equation. For example, you might have one that looks like this. Y equals X. See where that line is? So you're going to have to reflect over that line. Sometimes using patty paper could help because then you would have to flip it this way to get your image. Which I don't know if we're... I don't know if I can get that example to pull up, but there you go.